Well, we're back in the toy collector's attic.
We certainly are.
We're playing with toys.
Yes.
Because that's what we do here.
We do.
And actually, what sort of inspired this week is Christmas.
Yes.
Because we started reminiscing about, first of all, why anybody in their right mind collects toys.
Right.
And that the jury's still out on that because we're not sure that anybody in their right mind actually does.
Are we in our right mind?
That's the question.
Yes.
But part of what we're after is seeking some connection with our childhood.
Mm-hmm.
And in part, we're trying to get a hold of toys that we had as a kid that got waylaid over the years and
right.
trying to get back to that.
Mm-hmm.
And reconnect with the fun that we had with our toys. And it's just really neat when you can find some toy that you had when you were 8 years old or
right.
even, you know, 6 years old or something, and mm-hmm. suddenly you're holding a duplicate of the same thing that you found on eBay or something.
Right.
And it's very satisfying.
And, yeah.
and it allows you to sort of reconnect with that. But the other thing is at times it seems that as kids, there were those toys that we really wanted.
Yes, the Christmas that you wanted the toy you did not get.
And Santa Claus didn't bring, you know, because he said you'll shoot your eye out.
Right, that sort
and
of thing.
You'll shoot your eye out. And
right.
you don't get the BB gun or something.
Uh-huh.
And the whole rest of your life, you remember not getting that toy.
Right, and you still wanted it.
And you still wanted it, and
mm-hmm.
you still do. You know,
right.
you're 60 years old, and you're still
you still want
the
that
dang toy. That you never had a chance to
yeah.
get, or the toy that got waylaid and mislaid and
mm-hmm.
and discombobulated or something.
Right.
And sometime back, Karen was reminiscing about a toy that
oh
she never
gosh.
Got for Christmas that she really wanted.
Yes.
It's that
this
thing.
Is it.
That thing right there.
The Cox Trike. I was probably, I'm thinking 12 or 13 years old, and they had these the Cox Trikes. I mean, they have a real motor. They really run. And I wanted this when I was about 12 years old. And it actually, you know, you could start it, put gasoline, Cox fuel in it.
Uh-huh.
And I tried to talk my mom and dad in. I reasoned. This one I found on eBay, it's red. The one I saw at Kmart years ago was pink. And I reasoned, Mom, Dad, look, it's for girls, it's pink. And they're giving me the stink eye.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm getting old enough now where it's kind of, past toys.
Well, I think the stink eye was probably generated by the price.
The price was
this
terrible.
This was an expensive little toy.
$75 back in 71 or 2.
Yeah, so that's
right.
the equivalent
a lot of money.
I don't know, $400 now.
Easy, yeah.
$500
right.
now. This was an expensive toy.
Mm-hmm.
And so just because you asked Santa Claus for it didn't mean that you were actually
oh, but that's
going
all
to
I
get
wanted,
it.
You know. And of course my mom reasoned I needed school clothes, you know, the latest fashions, and you're getting older now where you should be interested in fashions, not three-wheeled trikes. I mean, they felt bad for me. And I did manage to find this one on eBay. It needs a lot of work. I'm currently working on it. It's kind of fun to work on these things. This is incredibly dirty. I did get one of the tires put on as the other tires were flat, and I was able to secure new tires.
The other tires had completely eroded away to
oh,
nothing.
Yeah.
We found these on eBay. There's a person on there selling hundreds of these things.
Right.
So they're readily available.
Sure.
And boy, they fit the Cox Trike. So if
yes.
you're going to rebuild a Cox Trike, look for the Goodyear Eagles on eBay, and there they are, and they fit perfectly.
Or you can buy one already restored. I just found one for $900 already restored.
That's a little bit more than they used to
oh,
be.
Oh, but they are. And I get a joy out of restoring things. And
but even one in this condition is going to set you back several hundred dollars.
Oh, easy, easy,
yeah,
easy.
You just don't find these things, and mm-hmm. when you do, they're usually in this kind of shape.
Right. All the pieces
and,
are here.
We've got to rebuild the engine. There's
right.
know, Karen's got her work cut out for her.
Right.
And then we'll bag some Cox fuel. You know what the Cox fuel is?
It's jet fuel, isn't it?
It's nitromethane.
Oh, that one.
It's like out of fuel dragsters. It's
okay,
nitromethane.
Yeah. Well, all I know is my dad just kind of his mouth fell open because, you know, that's got a real motor in it, right? And I'm like, yeah, Dad, I know. I understand. I just want one, please.
But I had the Cox Corvette.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah. Same idea, yep. same size, same everything, same
mm-hmm.
kind of general price.
Mm-hmm.
The thing had a top speed of around 30 miles an hour.
You,
not
tether,
scale,
you tethered them so they
30,
didn't run
yeah.
away.
I ran mine down a wire. You could set it up to either go around in a circle or straight down a wire with a catcher at one end, which is how I preferred to run mine.
Or stand up there and go, come back!
Come back! Yeah, if you let it go, you'd never see it again.
No remotes back then.
Yeah, no radio control, none of that. And this thing would take off and run out its fuel tank. So you might not ever see it again.
If might get stuck under a truck.
Yeah. I never even saw the Cox trike go. No. So I'm not sure how well they worked at all.
But, you know, all wasn't lost. My parents weren't mean or anything like that. And I did get a chopper trike for Christmas that year. This was a shaker trike. It was a dual quad 327 Chevy powered chopper trike by Carl Casper. You know, it was a really cool model. And of course, I was disappointed I didn't get the Cox trike, but my parents understood my love for building models, and so I got this one. And this isn't the actual one. I found this one on eBay as well, because I got thinking, you know, Carl Casper. But I got thinking, is he still around? Are his models still around? And I looked on eBay, and sure enough, there was a model, and it was sent right out to me, the exact same model. It's a reproduction. But I put this together, and I was sorely disappointed again, because as you can see, the handlebars are really fine, and so my dad and I couldn't figure out how to keep them glued on, as glues back then were horrible.
Right.
They didn't stay glued, they destroyed the model, pulled the chrome off. I had to keep a pencil wedged between the blowers up here and the handlebars to keep it from falling down, which didn't look too cool on my model shelf, but such was life back then. But this was pretty cool.
That's a neat model.
Uh-huh.
V8 trikes are just really cool.
Yes.
Oh. Ed invented those.
Oh, yes. Oh, Ed Roth.
Yeah, he had the whole story. The very first V8 trike, he went and found the powertrain out of a 65 Mustang GT, put a seat and a Harley fork on it, and rode it around.
Wow.
He said it went real fast.
I imagine. My biggest concern with this was, you know, if you really had this model, can you imagine climbing into the passenger area over the exhaust pipes? Ow!
Not terribly practical. It's a show bike.
But it was cool.
It was never really intended to go anywhere. It's neat.
Yeah, I don't know what happened to my original one, you know, forever. It sat on my dresser in my bedroom with the pencil holding the handle. I'm going to. Do we have a pencil?
We're going to make it work without the pencil. We're going to find a way.
I hope so, because, you know, it won't be complete without my yellow school pencil holding the handlebars up.
And we're going to get this shaker trike working. She's going to completely rebuild it.
Yeah.
And she's very good at this sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And by golly, we'll share that with you when we get it up and running and send it down to Tether.
Yes. See what happens.
Well, there you go. Another fine collector's attic on the Cox Shaker Trike.
Yes.
And if you haven't been over to the channel, do pop on over to the channel. And while you're over at the channel, you want to subscribe. Because subscribing means that you'll be notified every time we upload something. And the blue button for subscribing will be popping in. Do you want to do the honors?
Yes.
It's right down, zoink, right there. Blue button says subscribe, unless your phone is turned the wrong way or something and your device doesn't support it. Anyway, we're not sure how you found this movie on the internet. We hope you didn't find it boring, and we will see you here again on Sunday with the regular show.
Mm-hmm.
See you then. Bye-bye.
Bye.